Welcome to the Christian Arts Museum. The Christian Arts Museum is a free museum. We do not charge admission. We operate solely by donations. Here at the Christian Arts Museum, you will find things such as our painting here by Kenneth Wyatt. Kenneth Wyatt was a Texas artist, and he painted the apostles. We also have our wall of crosses done by a Fort Worth artist. Her name is Rachel Joy Coleman. And then over here we have a replica of the Ark of the Covenant along with Aaron the High Priest.
Wow, this is so nice, man. How long has this Christian Art Museum been here?
The Art Museum opened in 2009.
Wow.
And we've been operating ever since. We're open every Tuesday through Saturday.
Okay.
From 10 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Okay, what's the address?
The address is 3221 Hamilton.
Okay, and we'll have it on the credits too.
Right.
We'll have it on credit. So let's take a look at this. Talk to us about this new cross, man. I love this.
This is our latest piece. This is called the Black Christ. It is from Guatemala.
Okay.
It is 184 years old now.
Okay.
The legend of the Black Christ came years ago when a farmer saw the Black Christ once and then saw the Black Christ the second time.
Wow.
This was found in an abandoned Catholic church in Guatemala. The couple that found it took it home, kept it for many years, and then at their passing, their family brought it here and left it here on indefinite loan to the museum.
Wow.
Then we do have an almost 500-year-old Russian Orthodox icon.
Oh, wow.
Along with some statues, some coins that date back to the Roman period, a scroll written in Hebrew that's about 400 years old.
Wow.
And some lamps that date back to the time of Jesus.
Okay, wow. This the original?
Those are not original. Those are replicas. Those were used in a movie called The Vine.
Oh, okay. Wow.
It was made back in the late 60s, early 70s.
Okay. So you can go to YouTube and check that movie out.
I haven't been able to find it.
Okay.
Yeah, it's before YouTube. Way before YouTube.
Oh, okay. Wow. And talk to us about this right here. This is so unique, too.
That is a statue of King Hezekiah. That was done by Miss Rachel Joy Coleman. This piece of stone was from here in Fort Worth. It was down in the area called Hell's Half Acre.
Oh, okay.
Down in Fort Worth, where the Fort Worth Convention Center is today.
Wow.
That area used to be home to all the brothels and saloons, things like that. It was right across from the train station.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Well, when they went to clear the land to build the Tarrant County Convention Center, mm-hmm. the contractor said he couldn't bring it himself to just take this marble and throw it into a landfill somewhere. So he donated it to the Fort Worth School of Modern Art, where Miss Coleman was a student. And
oh,
she
wow.
said she saw King Hezekiah in this piece and had to carve it.
Wow. That's amazing. Okay. What about the, and do you got anything from the Holy Land? Do we got?
We do not have it. Well, we do not have anything from the Holy Land mm-hmm. other than this nativity here that's carved from olive wood. It did come from Israel.
Oh, now which one over here?
The nativity scene there.
Oh, okay.
That is an olive wood nativity scene.
Oh, wow.
It did come from Israel.
Okay, wow.
Then we have our 18th century painting of Daniel in the Lion's Den.
Wow. This is amazing. And then what about this right here?
That is the head of the Virgin Mary. That is a replica of the head of the Virgin Mary from Michelangelo's Bietta.
Oh, wow.
This is one of 100 that was authorized to be made by the Vatican.
Okay, wow. This is amazing.
Then, of course, over here we have our...
This is new. I've never seen this before.
Yes, this is our artist of the month.
Okay.
Every month or every other month, we have a new artist come to display their work.
Okay.
This month and next month, it will be Julie Clark.
Okay.
Miss Clark does all her work in wood.
Wow.
She does it all by hand on the scroll saw.
Okay. Wow. This is amazing.
And then, of course, The largest piece we have is in the next room, and it is the
Lowest
life-size Last Supper display.
Okay, tell us a little bit about that.
Well, that was done back in the
1950s. 1950.
It was created by two German artists. Both of them were named Catherine Stuberg.
Okay.
The Stubergs were commissioned to do it by Mr. and Mrs. William Fleming here in Fort Worth.
Why?
Mr. and Mrs. Fleming saw the original, and they decided that Fort Worth needed one of their own. So
right.
They had the piece commissioned.
Wow.
It first went on display here in Fort Worth in 1956.
Mm.
And until we took it out in 2009, it had been in storage for 12 years.
Wow.
So we were very happy to have it out where it can be seen and appreciated.
So let's take the people back there. All right, we're going to go back there, you guys, and see the Lord's Supper. Now, this is...
spot, knowing this will be their last meal together before